नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय।
हरि ओम। पंचवक्त्रः मीन्स द वन हु हैज फाइव हेड्स, ईशान, तत्पुरुष, अघोर, वामदेव and Sadyojata. These are the five heads of Lord Shiva. Sometimes these are also called as Pancha Brahma or the five forms of Shiva also. So these forms are also responsible for five different aspects. First form, Ishana, representing Krida. Second form, Tatpurusha, representing Tapasya. Third form, Aghora, representing Loka Samhar. Fourth form, Vamadeva, representing the Samashti, Ahankar. And the fifth form, Sadyojata, is representing the Jnan. So each form, each head also has a specific attribute. So there are five great tasks that the Lord does: Srishti, Sthiti, Samhara, Tirobhava, and Anugraha. Srishti is the creation, Sthiti is sustenance, Samhara is destruction, Tirobhava is to transform from one form to the other. Tirobhava literally means to cover, but it means the jiva dropping one form and going into the other. And Anugraha is the grace of the Lord by which the jiva gets free from this cycle of birth and death. So these five correspond to the earlier: Krida, Tapasya, Loka Samhar, Samashti, Ahankar, and Jnan. Of these five actions, four are connected to Srishti and the last one is connected to Mukti. So Srishti, Sthiti, Samhar, Tirobhav are connected with the creation. And Anugraha, by which one gets Jnan, is connected to Mukti, Moksha. Interesting is that these five are also connected to the five elements. Earth is for Srishti. Earth is a basis of the creation of all the beings. Then comes water. Through water we sustain ourselves. And how true it is that today science also tells us that we need to hydrate ourselves well. With fire is the destruction, samhara. Fire burns everything to ashes. Air or vayu represents movement. So when the prana comes out of the body and takes up another form, in the Gita also Bhagavan says that Vayur Gandha Nivashayat. Just like the wind carries the fragrance from the flower, in that way the subtle body ejects out of the gross body and takes up another form. And Akash is the symbol of Anugraha. It accommodates everything. And also Anugraha and Jnan, because subtlest or the closest to Brahman is Akash. To realize the absolute truth, one can contemplate on space, because we can't see, hear, taste, smell, touch space. So these five krityas of the Lord, the five actions of the Lord, represented by the five forms or the five faces of the Lord, are also connected to the five elements. The Lord also says that by His grace, Brahmaji got the first action. Brahmaji got the responsibility of Srishti from the great Paramashiva. Vishnu Bhagavan got Sthiti. It is Rudra. Paramashiva became Rudra and he got the Samhara as well as Tirobhav. So Brahma, Vishnu and Rudra, they are able to do this in each Brahmanda by the grace of Paramashiva. But Anugraha, only Paramashiva has, who can bless the jivas with mukti, freedom from the cycle of birth and death. So this form of Lord Shiva with five faces, one in each direction and one in the center, is described beautifully in this shloka. Mukta apita payoda maukti kajapa varnair mukhai panchabhihi trakshai ranjitami shamindu mukutam purnendu koti prabham shulam tanka kripana vajra dahanat nagendra ghantang kushan pasham bhiti haram dadhanam amita kalpojvalam chintayet. The upper face of Lord Shiva is described as whitish yellow in color. The eastern face is described as golden in hue. The southern face is described like the dark cloud, the rain-bearing cloud. The western face is described like the white complexion, like the sphatic crystal. And the northern face is like the red color, like the japa pushpa. This form is effulgent like crores of suns, and in his 10 hands there are various weapons. There is a snake, there is fire, and one hand is the hand of anugraha or abhaya hasta. The shloka says, I meditate on this glorious form of the Lord. So there is an interesting story described by Lord Shiva to Mother Parvati in the Anushasanika Parva of Mahabharata. The devatas once wanted to tempt Lord Shiva and test his concentration power, his abidance in yoga, his abidance in vairagya, dispassion. So they sent one of the most beautiful apsaras called Tilottama. Now this Tilottama, she cannot come there and say that I have come to tempt you. So she plays smart. She says, I have come here, O Lord, to do your pradakshina. But really in her mind, her motive was to tempt the Lord. So she bows down to the Lord and she does pradakshina. Now Bhagwan thought, let me teach her a lesson. And Bhagwan knew that it is devatas who have sent, so indirectly let the devatas also learn the lesson. As Tilottama was doing pradakshina, Bhagwan kept looking at her, and hence four heads extra appeared to see Tilottama without moving this first head. So symbolically, without getting disturbed, without getting distracted, his face remains the same, and yet he is able to see Tilottama as she completes the whole pradakshina, and there is not a single thought of lust in his mind. Tilottama tries to tempt the Lord in different ways as she is doing the pradakshina, but Bhagwan is unaffected. So this is the story of how the five heads also manifested. They are a manifestation of the abidance of the Lord in yoga, in vairagya, in dhyan, in dharana, in concentration. And the devatas Tilottama both learned their lesson. They prostrated to the Lord. She went. So the learning from the story is that when we are anchored within, nothing from outside can even tempt us, distract us. Our mind will remain focused. Not only Lord Shiva has these five faces, all of us also have these five faces. Srishti, Sthiti, Samhar. We also create, sustain and destroy so many things. We also transform. And all this happens when our mind is positive, and with the grace of such a positive, focused, powerful mind, we are able to achieve. And yet we are able to transcend all this also. Just like many times we see on the beach when the children are playing, they only create the mud house and they create a bridge and they create some garden to play. Everything is created by them through the mud. And they have various toys which help them to create all these. And they also enjoy that, and they only destroy it. Bhagwan creates like that, this whole universe, sustains it, destroys it, transforms it, and finally liberates the jivas also by his anugraha. So each of us, we create, sustain, destroy, transform, and transcend also. At a certain phase, there are certain emotions, there are certain things that we seek, we want to enjoy, we want to achieve, and we transform ourselves for it. And after some point, we even transcend that desire, transcend those stages. So we also have these five faces. What is important to understand here is, all this can be done when the mind is free from desire, lust, passion, etc. Then this entire thing will become like a sport. If there is desire, attachment, selfishness in the mind, then each of these may cause some trouble or the other. Creation also will be a pain, sustenance will be more difficult, destroying absolutely difficult, transforming, we have a lot of resistance, and the mind is not having anugraha, it doesn't have a positive attitude. So along with Bhagwan having the five faces and five forms, five actions that the Lord does, each of us also have all these. So may that Supreme Lord help us to live in this life with the attitude that this is a sport. And in and through that, may we seek the grace of the Lord and transcend this sport and experience our oneness with the absolute truth. While we live here, we live fearlessly, with strength, with courage, with detachment, with focus, like Lord Shiva. And with the grace of Lord Shiva, we transcend this and realize oneness with the Supreme. Om Panchavaktraya Namaha.
Om Namah Shivaya.